Hello and good day. I hope you are doing well today. In this video, we are going to show you how you can use Excel to do selection of gearbox and actuator. It's very simple and very easy. So let us start. Here, as you can see, this is already been populated. So I will just remove these torque values. Okay, now it is not available. Here you can see is a small table of size, rating, pressure and seat. This is for ball valve, and we have a torque value, say ball valve torque value, which is say 100, 200, 300, 400. The moment you start putting this torque value, you are getting the gearbox values also, as well as the model number along with the price also. This will be price. So there are two vendors and you have two prices available. The backup work here is not that difficult actually. You can just, you can get the maximum torque for any of the vendor, all the values, their model numbers and their prices. So this is for one and this is for another one. Okay. This two, suppose if it is more than 35,000, then it will show not in range. Let me show you this. Say this is say 30,000, then it will show not available and not in range, like that. Or if this is say we are not putting any value, for example, I will just remove this. This is zero, so this will show as dash. Okay. Now what we have done is it's not that difficult actually, it's very, very simple, but I wanted to show you because in gearbox selection we are taking a lot of time, especially if you are doing manually selecting a gearbox, for 200 tag it will take at least 2 to 3 hours. In this you can do it in less than 15 minutes. So let me show you how gear. It's a big formula, but the logic is that is simple. If we have used the formula of if H3 is 0, which is this value is 0, then you put a dash, and if H3 is between 150, less than 150, then you put 150 as a value here, and based on 150, so this value, you can simply put a VLOOKUP. So here you will have a value depending upon what is the torque value you are getting here. Let's say if it is say 102, so this becomes 153, and the next 153 is 330, so it will be 330. And we put all the range here, complete range. It looks difficult, but if you try it once, it's the same logic that if the H3 value, which is this value, is between 151 and 330, then you put 330. If it is between 331 and 500, so we are taking each values here. If it is between 0 and 150, then you put this. If it is between these two, you put this. If it between these two, you put. So we are using the same logic up till 32,000, and we are generating this torque value. Once we have this torque value, we are just using a VLOOKUP to calculate this value. Again, this also we are just calculating based on the model number. So whatever model number is will come based on that, price will come directly. And this is for one vendor. The same thing we have done it for another vendor. So again, we have taken value from here, and we are using the same logic that just values will change, because here it was 150, here it is 250. See, the lowest one was 150 and here it is 250. So if our torque value, for example, let me show you a simple one. Say our value for this one, see, here it is 102 torque value, 153 multiplying by safety factor. You can change the safety factor also. This simple formula. So here I will put 1.5 just to show you. Here the model is with a torque value of 330, so price is say 2. Here we are selecting the first model number itself and the price is 1. So this is the difference. So you can have multiple vendors and table like this. Simply torque value, model, and the prices. You can have such arrangements. I've just put this as a multiplier. So if you want, like suppose you want to consider the packing or the cost, the freight cost from the vendor place to your place. So you can multiply, say, you can take 2% extra. So 1.02. In this fashion, you can see how you can manage everything from. So you manage the cost and on from these tables both, and then just by putting these values, this again it will come from the quotation table itself. So you don't have to put anything. Maybe you have to just put the torque and you get this table directly. This you can automate everything by using macros also, but I've shown you a much simpler way of doing it is by using a formula. So this is one part. This is for gearbox. Let me show you a little more complicated, that is how to do selection for the actuator. For actuator, we have again here we are considering the ball valve selection only, and in the ball valve there are six torque, three on the opening side and three during the closing time. So we will have, let me show you that first. So okay, so we will have three torque on the air side and three will be on the spring side. As you can see here, there are six torque values. All this in the yellow cells are input. We are considering air pressure as 5 bar and fill gloss condition close. So with this, if you want to see what is the model number, you calculate, it is showing as 34. Price is 3400. These two is coming from here, so this is 34. So these are the torque value is comparing. Let me, yeah, this is the torque value, and based on this we are getting the price as 3400. Okay, so I mean here also many time it happens that we are doing it manually. We are each we have this table and then we go and try to locate each values, and then we say okay, this is the right model. But in this way you just have to put the torque values and you can calculate the, you can get the model directly. It's very easy, very simple. I will show you the code also for this. So we will just go Alt F11. Just a moment here. So we for pressure 3 bar, 4 bar and 5 bar with close conditions, we are comparing each values for this. Then we have for open, again we are just comparing values with for sheet 2. So this is, just a moment, sorry, this sheet 2 we are just comparing the values, these values with different values. Okay, this is for open condition in stay put or double acting actuator. So we are again for 3 bar, 4 bar and 5 bar, and you can calculate using this method. Thank you.